First, we got Mr. Sean Rose. I've been meaning to do that for a while.
Okay.
How you doing, Sean? And he's going to be bringing us the story, information about the stories, making the news this week. What's up, Sean? What's the big news? What's the big events?
Big is indeed a good way to describe it, because this evening we're looking at gender equity, and it is a big issue. I should welcome our viewers out there and say that gender equity in the BVI is something that is becoming a concern for many people, particularly those in the gender affairs unit in the Ministry of Health and Social Development. What we are recognizing, Edurenka, is something that is region-wide. And I should say that most of what we're going to say will be based on some findings coming out of work done by the UWI Cavill campus and also the Mona campus, in particular Professor Brown in the case of Cavill and Professor Barry Chavans, the late Barry Chavans, out of Mona. Now, according to, let's get some definitions on the table. The United States Agency for International Development, USAID, says that gender as a construct or as a social mechanism, as a category, was first introduced in the 60s and 70s. And you may know that that's when women's rights also became very popular throughout the world. And intrinsically, gender equality occurs when males and females have equal conditions to social and economic opportunities to advance their lives, basically. And for years, the Caribbean has been saddled with gender inequality. Let's say after adult suffrage in 1950, we have been saddled with gender inequality. And for the most part, many people have been laying the blame either on the female side or on the male side. But where do you think we should really lay focus our attention, and not necessarily lay blame to address the issue of gender equality? Because here in the BVI today in 2013, it is argued that women are dominating the workforce.
Women are dominating the workforce. Well, that's interesting. You do see a lot of women in the workforce, and we got three women on the show tonight. and top management, top level positions in the HWD South Community College. So that's an indication, if you want to take a poll, that's an indication of the success of women's society. But there's something interesting that you said there, Sean. And historically, I'm not sure that in the BVI, we looked at we looked at the roles of females and males through from the perspective of gender inequality. It seemed to me when I was growing up that the quote-unquote gender roles were accepted in the society. There weren't any arguments about who should do what or who's discriminated against and who's getting more money. It was, I know that it was that mothers took care of the home and took care of the children, and fathers provided for the family. And it seems to me like that role was accepted, and out of that role in that family unit came some very, very strong individuals, both males and females.
Arguably so, but there were a number of issues as well that permeated societies, not only here in the BVI, I'm sure, but throughout the Caribbean. Now, let's look at the gender roles that were once accepted, now are changing. As we know, culture is very dynamic, and we can understand that the role of the family, that's where gender roles are first inculcated into our minds. And, for instance, boys are taught that their role in terms of chores and so forth is outside of the house, maybe to assist with cleaning up the yard and so forth. The girls, traditionally I should say, are being taught that their role is to assist with chores inside of the house. These girls become teenagers, become young women, and young, and of course, married women, for the most part. The same applies to the males, young men, and eventually they become husbands. Now, when at the adult level, they have a difficulty transitioning out of what they were taught all of their life to now assisting their wives with chores in the house, issues arise. When the wife has difficulty transitioning outside of the home to perform chores outside of the house, I should say, to perform chores in the outside, that also leads to issues. And domestic violence has been you know, showing its ugly head in various forms. And believe you me, based on what the research has shown, we can really point the blame as far as domestic violence are concerned, and of course other issues surrounding instability in the home, to the way we were socialized as young men and women.
Well, I was about to say that the socialization process certainly was one where the male was taught their roles and the female was taught their roles in the environment, much as you mentioned. And when that dynamic changed, I don't know that males in particular were able to adjust readily to the shift in roles. And I have to blame it, you know, and I know, you know, we like to say we need to stop the blame game, but I think we need to, it needs to be always point out where the responsibility for actions lie.
Yes.
And I think that, I was in America during the late 60s and the 70s when the feminist movement came about, as you mentioned. And I attribute a lot of the gender strife and difficulties to that feminist movement, where the women in America, feeling disenfranchised, sought to quote unquote gain equality and change the roles, acceptable roles, the traditional roles of women in that society. In the BVI, I know many, many, many women in the BVI who were business women. You know, I could go down a list. Miss Helen, Miss Flossie, Miss Amabel, Miss Baby, you know, a list of women who had stores, you know, little grocery stores, engaged in cottage, Miss Estelle, engaged in cottage industries to help support their families.
Yes.
And so women and men,
yes,
when I was growing up, when I was a child, they didn't have no clue about roles. They did what was necessary to keep the family unit,
yes,
together,
yes,
to make sure their children were well-mannered, very clean, well-fed, and got an education. There was no gender war.
But let's accept precisely that in the Caribbean context, the cottage industries played a very important role in ensuring that women were empowered. And it's really empowerment that are at the crux of the matter here. But let's look at what's happening now. Men are at risk. In fact, Professor Errol Miller, he wrote in 1994, in the 1990s, I believe it's 1991, he said, men at risk. And he made the argument suggesting that more women were now matriculating out of secondary and tertiary level institution at that time already. Mm-hmm. And the positions in the workforce were being taken over by females. On the other hand, the males were non-existent for the most part. In Dominica, however, concerns were rising as well, because what was happening, though, they had a number of males who were qualified but were not given jobs because they were not considered appropriate or best suited enough for the jobs. In fact, gender roles played a role there, because here again, we saw the phenomenon of the idea that women were best suited for secretarial and clerical jobs, whereas men should go out there and get their hands dirty. And that really played a significant part in how Dominica decided they should, some employers in Dominica decided who they should employ at both the government and the private sector level. And Professor Barish Evans, he warned initially, prior to the turn of the 21st century, that the role ascribed to young men in the home is affecting their ability to function as husbands and also to function as heads of corporations and so forth. So as we look at the arguments for and against, we can safely say that we need to pay more attention to what's happening in the homes. We are now seeing the penetration of media from so many different angles, and of course the cultural penetration that comes via the media sources that are impacting how families function or not function in some cases. So, for example, the traditional nuclear family is out of the window in some areas, in some cultures, in some societies, and we're now told to accept alternative family structures, persons who are pursuing alternative lifestyles and not necessarily the traditional male gender and female gender in the home.
Yeah. Well, certainly I think the society here in the BVI is becoming fearful that there's going to be a lack of eligible men for family building and for species generation. And now you see that I think you can discern the tide shifting from the encouragement of the female to the encouragement of the male, that the male now seem to need more encouragement. And you notice it at graduation, you notice it in certain areas where, you know, the emphasis is placed on how many boys are enrolled in college, yes, how many boys graduate this year as opposed to girls. And if you have an increase in boys, there's a loud clap. If a boy makes it to the top of the class, there's a loud clap,
yes,
you know, as a big applause.
So in the 60s and 70s, Cromwell, you had a feminism-based groups. Should we have masculine-based groups in the 21st century?
We're not going to have a masculinist movement. What we are having, I think, is a shift towards recognizing the imbalance. We've gone too much to one side, and now we need to come back and encourage the males and the females so that we could have a harmonious society. So it starts in the homes. Interesting discussion, interesting topic.
A lot more can be said. Women rule in politics. It's minimal in some cases, yet they are dominating the workforce.
We're looking forward to the news story this weekend. Should make for interesting viewing. Make sure you tune in to JTV News live here on Channel 55 for the events, the stories and events taking shape this week.
Spotlight is brought to you by the National Bank of the Virgin Islands, Clarence Thomas Limited, the BVI Tourist Board, and CCT Global Communications.